Wavelet Theory and Its Applications. This course is brought to you by Gilad James Mystery School. Learn more at giladjames.com. Introduction. In this section, let us discuss some fundamentals which are required to understand wavelets. Signals which are coming from a source are normally in time domain. Examples are sinusoidal signal, biomedical signal, etc. Any time domain signal can be processed or transformed into frequency domain, spectral domain, using mathematical transformations. Fourier transform is one of the popular or famous transform that will convert a time domain signal into frequency domain signal without any loss of generality. While plotting time domain signal, we use time in the x-axis and amplitude in the y-axis. The hidden information present in the signal cannot be revealed in the time domain, hence a transform domain is required. The frequency content or spectrum of a signal is simply the frequency content, spectral components, of the signal. The frequency spectrum of a signal depicts what are all the frequencies exist in the signal. When plotting frequency domain, we use frequency in the x-axis and amplitude in the y-axis. Normally for any signal, if the frequency content is not changing with respect to time is called a stationary signal. Example can be a sinusoidal signal where the frequency xhg is not changing irrespective of the cycle. Unfortunately, real-time signals are non-stationary signal where the frequency content of the signal is keeping on changing. The best example is biological signals. Suppose when we are looking at an ECG, electrocardiograph, signal. The typical shape of a healthy ECG signal is well known to cardiologists. Any significant deviation from that shape is usually considered to be a symptom of a pathological condition. Doctors analyze these cases not only in time domain, they are using frequency domain also to confirm the pathological condition. Fourier transform, FT to understand wavelets, let us go deep into the literature. The first and main contribution regarding the frequency content or spectrum came from the French mathematician Jean-Baptiste Fourier. He showed that any periodic function can be represented as an infinite sum of periodic complex exponential functions and named as Fourier transform, FT. X, 1, and 2, represent the forward and inverse Fourier transform. Where xt represents the time domain signal, xj omega, represents the frequency content of the signal and ohm equals 2 times pi times f and 3, represents that any complex exponential is expressed as real part of cosine function and imaginary part of sine function with the corresponding frequency. As per 1. The input signal is multiplied with cosine function and sine function at all the time intervals and added, integrated, to yield the frequency content. The concept is best illustrated in figures 1 and 2. Figure 1 shows the implementation at analysis side. Here, each blue-colored square is a narrow-band pass filter with a cutoff frequency omega 0, omega 1. Fourier transform analysis side. Fourier transform synthesis side. Figure 2 shows the implementation at synthesis side. Here also, each blue-colored square is a narrow-band pass filter with a cutoff frequency omega 0, omega 1. In figure 1, if the result of the particular filter is large, then we can understand that the particular frequency component is dominant. If there is no output in any filter means that the particular frequency component is zero, i.e., single signal is passed multiple filter and the outputs are analyzed and the reverse is happening in figure 2 which is called a synthesis. To understand the above one, see the following illustration shown in figure 3 where the individual frequencies are indicated as 5, 25, and 50 Hz. The corresponding spectrum is shown in figure 4. Cosine signal with three different frequencies 5, 25, and 50 Hz. Spectrum cosine signal with three different frequencies 5, 25, and 50 Hz. Figure 5 indicates a signal which contains all the three frequencies 5, 25, and 50 Hz mixed together and its corresponding spectrum. Cosine signal with three combined frequencies 5, 25, and 50 Hz and its corresponding spectrum. Fourier transform is very much useful for a stationary signal. This means that Fourier transform clearly indicates what are all the frequency components exist in the given signal independent of time. Fourier transform completely fails for a non-stationary signal.